A president elected in history's biggest landslide, 19 months after his inaugural address, threatened with impeachment and removal from office. His vice president already gone, in disgrace. And now, hearing from the Supreme Court that a president, any president, must obey the law and the courts. Only in recent times, since the presidency began taking on the trappings and the arrogance of the Roman emperors, could this question have been seriously considered. The country has come a long way since Thomas Jefferson walked around Washington, eating in a boarding house, waiting his turn, to the time when one of his successors is officially informed by the highest court that he is not above the law. If any president ever were, that would be the end of it. He could be, or soon become, a dictator. Even in times as turbulent as ours, the remarkable thing is not how the court answered the question. The remarkable thing is that the question was ever asked.